sometimes the coolest technology just happens to be incredibly old technology, but like somehow repackaged, reconstituted for modern audiences, for lack of a better term. And well, I've been going down a bit of a rabbit hole. Or was it Wormhole? So I just recently rewatched my Wormhole video from 2019, and in that, I talk about how I've played with it years ago when I was checking in on the Wormhole technology. I had no idea that I'd been on this journey with Magic Wormhole thus far. But I'll link this video down below. It's much better than my current videos. I was much better at making YouTube videos years ago. Also, why is my voice so much higher? And I'm less gray and wrinkly and... look at that young, fresh-faced fool. But anyways, enough about me. We're going to focus on the evolution of the whole wormholiverse, I like to call it. So, a quick recap for those who don't want to watch that little video. Magic Wormhole was a little Python program, a little terminal program that ran your system, and you could use it to pipe a file from one computer anywhere on the internet to another computer. And all you had to know is a little magic code that it generated, and it would handle the rest, like magic, hence Magic Wormhole. But we live in whatever year this is, and in this year, we have apps, full-on smooth little applications that both run on your desktop and on your phone. So we're going to take a peek at some of the evolutionary options there is for Magic Wormhole. So I'm going to go back to the computer screen here. I'm going to type in, obviously I'm going to go to the original Magic Wormhole GitHub page. This is a Python application. This is the original, and everything has been kind of built off this. So, for example, we have wormhole, and that was RS. Now, this is a fork of Magic Wormhole written in Rust. And this is kind of important because Rust is a more, for lack of a better way of saying it, and it's a bit more of a portable language. Like, there are programs on the desktop that are more easily integrated with a Rust code versus a Python code. And I feel like that used to be like not the case, but here we are. But everything you can do with Magic Wormhole, including sending in files with the original Magic Wormhole, will work on Rusty Wormhole. I just now saw that. That's going to be a theme we're going to see, because we're going to look at the next one, which is Wormhole William. Now, this is a wormhole command line tool written in the Go language. Again, Rusty Wormhole, Wormhole William, these are fantastic names. They fill me with nothing but joy. But it doesn't end there, because these are just command line versions you can build other things on, and people have. I'm going to go over here to FlatHub. We're going to type in worm. See what pops up. I guarantee we're going to see some wormhole applications. What do you know? Here we are. We have, I'm not sure how to say this, RimDeport. And this one is a nice desktop GUI. It's got a very friendly to use, familiar interface. Anyone who's ever used a downloading program, this might seem familiar. And I've used this one, and this one actually has a decent Windows port that's nice to use. So I have a buddy of mine I've been sharing files with. And he ran this one. If we check out the links here, let's go look at their project website. And I believe this one is written in, shit, man, I don't even know. Oh, this is based on Wormhole Williams. This is the Go build. See, there's a reason for that. Now we have a nice GUI little program. And the cool thing about this is you can grab this copy, set the file. And when you're on the desktop, you might have your chat window open. You drop the little text thing in there. Nice encrypted connection between what? That's the thing. This is an encrypted connection between point to point, which is dope. So let's look at the other one. The one that got me the most excited right here. This is Warp. Warp is not just good because of how simple it is, but warp, if we go to the official website, this is a gnome app. That's right. This is part of Gnome's Circle project, which are supposed to be dedicated apps made by the Gnome team for the Gnome desktop environment, or GNOME if you're nasty. And this one, I believe, if I remember correctly, is based on the Rust version, I think. Let's find out. Let's look at the, here we have the GitLab here. And sure enough, I think I saw this before. Boop. Yeah, Rust. So you have one of the desktop applications made with the Go, and another desktop application made with Rust. And again, they all work together. Okay, so I got the broken brain here, but I need to take a minute to remind you, to tell you that there's a few programs like this one, webwormhole.io. It looks like it's gonna work with Magic Wormhole. It actually works the same concept where you create the wormhole, you have your short code, you pop it in. But as far as I can tell, this is a different protocol, similar idea. It looks like it's open source. Let's click this over here. This is not compatible with Magic Wormhole. Okay, it says peer authenticated WebRTC. Apparently I like this, I don't know when, but I liked it at one point. But it is not the same as the Magic Wormhole. This is, here we go. Web Wormhole is inspired and uses a model similar to that of Magic Wormhole. Not compatible, so if you try using it, you're gonna have a bad time. Here I wanna show you a program. I think this is simply titled Wormhole File Transfer. Now I'll have to get the link exactly where that is from. I'm not sure if that's part of the FDroid store or the add-on repository. But either way, this seems to be a pretty good little program if it wants to load. There it goes. And obviously, if you look on the phone here, it's not connected to my Wi-Fi, obviously, for experimental sake. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select a file to copy over. And there we go. We're going to click on the receive 9-rack it here. Egghead. Simple as that. Like that could have been copy and pasted into a text message. Ask to receive the file, finds the connection, and accept. And what do you know? Boom, the file is copied to my desktop. I can open the file. And there you go. There's my little JPEG. So it works really slick. And this also could be done from Android phone to Android phone, from warp to warp to warp to command line. You can install the command line version of warp RS in Termux. It's in the default repository. There's lots of options for that, and it works really good. And it works better now than it has ever worked. And again, because you're going from hardware to hardware through the internet, and I think there's only like a node in the middle to handle the handshake, file size limit does not exist. You can go as big as you want to. I'm not gonna lie, it's been a bit of a brain melter looking at how long I've been using some of these technologies and how they've evolved, and they've gone from kind of obscure command line apps that I just thought were really neat to something that I can actually talk my friends into using, which is also really neat in its own kind of way. Would it be awesome if everyone used badass terminal-only applications? Yeah, but eventually you got to make tools to go to where people are. And I guess that's something I've learned in my incredibly old age, is eventually you have to make the tools for the people. Otherwise, people are not going to use them. As much as I love command line applications, having a nice GUI, friendly to use, or even browser-based solution, definitely a good thing to have, providing it's not used to also, you know, control, manipulate, and spy on people. Tall order, I know, but I think we can do it. I think we can make the web better. Rant over. I've been on this platform for a long time, and I promise that all my videos in this year are not going to be me rehashing videos I already made 4 or 5 years ago. I can't guarantee I won't retread some earlier ground, but let's be real, that video only has like 400 views on it. I don't think anyone's gonna notice.